heavy for Mary to play outside, so she decided to explore the big old sad house. Up hallways and downstairs she went, turning corner after corner, wandering in and out of dusty rooms. She never saw anyone, but she heard someone crying. Who was it? Mary asked Martha that night. Just your imagination, Martha replied. The days grew longer and brighter as winter started to fade. Mary found that she could now skip all the way around the gardens without stopping even once. 98, 99, 100, Mary counted as she skipped. She rested by a wall covered in ivy, and she thought about the secret garden locked up and left all alone. Chirp, cried the robin, pecking at the dirt. Something green and glittered. A key! Had been alone for a long time. Brown, scratchy rose bushes climbed the trees and trailed from branch to branch. Years of fallen leaves covered the ground like a gray blanket. Was the garden dead or just sleeping? Something was alive. Something was struggling to reach the light and greet the spring. Mary took a big, deep breath and thought very hard. She loved the garden already, and more than anything, she wanted it to stay a secret. But she needed help. I need some advice, Mary told Martha, about a little garden. She did not say which one. You'll be wanting Dick, Martha said. Her brother So Martha sent
the foot.
And the moment Mary met Dickon, she knew she could trust him with any secret. With Dickon's help, Mary learned how to care for the garden.
About how the legs
go. As the spring came on, the garden burst to life.
There's flowers in the garden.
Yes, it's looking beautiful again, isn't it? Misselwaite Manor had one other secret. His name was Colin, and he was sick, sad, angry, and weak. It was Colin who had been crying that day, and it was Colin's crying that reached Mary's ears and brought her to him one stormy spring night. Are you a ghost? He asked her. Are you? Mary said. Colin's father was the master of Misselwaite Manor, but he was never home. Colin couldn't walk, and he hated it when people felt sorry for him, so he hid in his room and never went out. I don't feel sorry for you, Mary told Colin. She thought he was a bit like the garden. He'd been locked up and left alone for too long. Dickon had known how to help the garden. Maybe he would know how to help Colin too. So Mary brought Dickon to visit, and Dickon brought his animal. What you need, Dickon told Colin, is some fresh spring air.
Give him a snack.
Boy, he was